and pitied. Good morning, Historic First Baptist. Good morning, Salem. Good morning, New Hope. To everyone that is here in person, to all of our online viewers, and happy Mother's Day to all of the mothers that are here and everyone that is tuning in online. Again, as we always do every morning, we come for no other reason but to give God all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. Let's stand all over the building and let's worship him together. He deserves, demands, and desires all of our praise. For this is truly the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice. We will be glad. Come on, clap those hands all over this building and let's sing together. Let's worship the Lord. Let's sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You're worthy to be praised.
Come to freely give it to him. We come to lift his name up this morning. Let's sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you're worthy.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, we praise you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you're so worthy.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we
lift you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you're worthy.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, we praise your name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you're so worthy.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we
lift you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you're worthy.
Hallelujah. Have you come to lift up Jesus? Come on, clap those hands all over this building and let's give the Lord a praise.
Good morning, good morning, and good morning. Truly, the Lord is worthy of all our praise, worthy to be lifted up. Good morning, mothers. Truly, this is a great day, a day set aside as well to acknowledge those with us and those that have gone on. We know the importance of our mothers, and we love our mothers, and men, they played a great impact on our life as well. Amen. Let us read. The Old Testament is coming from Proverbs chapter 3, verses 1 through 8, and I'll be reading from the English Standard Version. My son, do not forget my teaching, but let your heart keep my commandments. For length of days and years of life and peace they will add to you. Let not steadfast love and faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart. So you will find favor and good success in the sight of God and man. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him and he will make straight your path. Be not wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and turn away from evil. It will be healing to your flesh and refreshment to your bones. Amen. Our New Testament reading is coming from Hebrews chapter 4. We'll be reading verses 1 through 15. It reads thus. Therefore, while the promise of entering his rest shall still stand, let us fear lest any of you should seem to have failed to reach it. For good news came to us just as to them, but the message they heard did not benefit them because they were not united by faith with those who listened. For we who have believed entered that rest, as he has said, as I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter my rest. Although his works were finished from the foundation of the world. For he has somewhere spoken of the seventh day in this way, and God rested on the seventh day from all his works. And again, in this passage, he said, they shall not enter my rest. Since therefore it remains for some to enter it, and those who formerly received the good news fail to enter because of disobedience. Again, he appoints a certain day, today, saying through David so long afterward, in the words already quoted, today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts. For if Joshua had given them rest, God would not have spoken of another day later on. So then, there remains a Sabbath rest for the people of God. For whoever has entered God's rest has also rested from his works, as God did from his. Let us therefore strive to enter that rest, so that no one may fall by the same sort of disobedience. For the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the division of soul and of spirit, of joints and of marrow, and discerning the thoughts and intentions of the heart. And no creature is hidden from his sight, but all are naked and exposed to the eyes of him to whom we must give account. Since then, we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast our confession. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect has been tempted as we are, yet without sin. The word of God for the people of God.
Anybody still got a praise for the Lord this morning? Anybody still excited to be in the house of the Lord? For truly, this is the day that he has made. I don't know about y'all, but I came to give him glory this morning. I came to give him all the honor and all the praise. So we asked some of the mothers what they wanted to hear this morning on Mother's Day. And they gave us some song selections. And then I coupled those songs with songs some of the old mothers used to sing when I was growing up. Y'all remember those old mothers used to sing some of these old songs? Y'all remember that? So we're going to sing some of those songs this morning. I don't feel no waste time. I've come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he brought me this far to live. Come on, let's sing together.
Said I don't feel no waste time.
Lord, I come too far
from where I started.
Nobody told me
that the road would be.
Come on, let's raise it up one more time. All those down. Said
I don't
feel
no way time.
Lord, I come too far
from where I started from.
Nobody told me that the road was. Anybody testify to that this morning? Lord, I don't believe. I know he did pray me this far to leave me.
I don't believe. He brought me this far to leave me.
Open the floodgates of heaven, let it rain. Does anybody want that this morning? Come on, let's worship. Sing, open
the floodgates
of heaven.
Jesus,
Lord. Come on, clap those hands all over the building. I said, if you know that you can depend on him, if you know you can count on him, if you know he promised to never leave you, promised to never forsake you, clap those hands all over this building. When my mother and my father forsake me, the Lord made me a promise that he will bear me up. When I'm feeling weak, that's when he is my strength. When I feel like I can't go on, he's always there. He said he'll never leave me, nor will he forsake me. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy gotta come in the morning. I said weeping may endure for a night, but joy's coming in the morning. And your morning is right now. You don't have to wait for it. Your morning is right now. If you believe it and receive it, clap those hands all over this building. And let's give the Lord a praise.
Church, we're going to say a happy Mother's Day to all the mothers, and we thank you all for being here today. Father God, we thank you for all you've done. Father, we thank you for this new and the first day. Father, we just want to say thank you to all the mothers. Father, we thank you for keeping them strong. Father, you know, they went through a lot in life. Father, it wouldn't be easy. Because if they didn't feel the bumps in the road, it's time for them to go back and get down on their knees. Father, all that we went through, Father, we just want to say thank you for you being there with us and you never left us. Father, we just want to say thank you. Through all the sick, we thank you, oh, Heavenly Father. All the trouble, the frustration in life, you've been there each and every day. Father, we just want to say thank you. Thank you, Father, and continue to keep us. Father, we thank you for fear in our life. Because without fear, we don't know which way to go. It's time for us to just fall down our knees, find that empty closet, and pray, and call on Jesus. Call on the name of Jesus each and every day. Father, whenever we feel in the pains, don't give up. Call on Jesus. Father, when we are lost, can't find a way, call on Jesus. Father, the one that we can depend on each and every day. Father, we thank you and thank you. Ask that you continue to keep us. Father, we ask that you give a traveling grace to those that are coming and those that made it this morning. Father, keep them and protect them. Father, we thank you for all of your blessing. And Father, we ask that you continue to bless each one of us one by one. Father, I don't know other situation. I don't know other sickness, but Father, you do. Be with them, Father. Remove the pain and give them joy. Father, we need you this morning. We need you each and every day. Father, we want to say thank you. Bless all the sick, not only at this church, but all over the country. There's so many things happening, Father, that we need you. All the killings are going on all over the world and right here in Jackson, Tennessee. Father, we need you. We need you right now. And Father, as we go forward, we ask that you would just show us the way. Keep us in your sight. We thank you for keeping us in your presence. And we just want to say thank you for it all. And Father, as we go to our seats, Father, we just want to say, God, we love you, and we thank you, and we ask that you would keep us, lead and guide us, Father. We ask this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, good morning, Historic First Baptist, Salem and New Hope. God bless you here this morning. Greetings in the matchless name of our Savior and yet our Lord Jesus Christ here on this morning. Happy Mother's Day to all mothers in the sanctuary, and for those also are viewing online, if you will you watch the screen? For we here at Historic First Baptist has a Mother's Day presentation we want you to watch here this morning. Thank you, media, for that beautiful presentation here on this morning. Is there any first-time visitors here in the sanctuary this morning? You don't have to stand. We just want to thank you for coming out and worshiping here with us this morning at Historic First Baptist, for we understand that you could have been anywhere in this city where the preached word of Jesus Christ is going forth in other churches as well as ours. Is there one? All right, we are all family. God bless you here this morning. Listen, also, let me share this. You can also find us online by the way of YouTube, okay? Facebook, and you can also find us on the website, www.historicfirstbaptist.org, all right? Well, listen, it is giving time. Yes, it is. Welcome to the second part of our worship. It is giving time. If I will, real quickly, let me draw your attention to the Old Testament book of Exodus, chapter 23, and verse 15. I'm going to be reading from the New Living Translation. Listen to these words. It says, first celebrate the festival of unleavened bread. For 7 days, the bread you eat must be made without yeast. Just as I commanded you, celebrate this festival annually at the point of time in early spring in the month of Ab. For that is the anniversary of our departure from Egypt. No one may appear before me without an offering. Listen, remember the New Testament, 2 Corinthians 9 through 6, excuse me, 9, chapter 9, 6 through 8 says, remember this, a farmer who plants only a few seeds will get a small crop, but the one who plants graciously will get a gracious crop. You must decide in your heart how much to give, and do not give reluctantly or response under pressure. For God loves a cheerful giver, and God will graciously provide all you need. Let me say that again. And God will provide all you need. Then you will always have everything you need and plenty left over to share with others. Listen. Let me also share this here with you. Giving is a ministry. It is not just something that we do. It is the tangible way in which we express our thanks to God for the tangible and spiritual ways in which He has and is blessing us right now. We know that we have been blessed to be a blessing, but also, we here at Historic First Baptist give out of obedience and honesty and in love and by faith. We give knowing that God has never asked us to give what we do not have He has never demanded us what he has not already invested in us. He is not asking us for a portion, a tenth from what we do not have, but a tenth and an offering from what he has allowed us to earn or be gifted with, for it is, let me put it this way, it all belongs to God. Amen? Amen. Listen, we here in the sanctuary of give traditionally, if you don't have an envelope, would you raise your hands now and then the ushers will make sure that you get an envelope here this morning. All right. There's other ways to give also, okay? But let me also inform you that this is Vision Sunday, all right? This is where we go just a little above our tithes and offering in our giving, okay? But also, you can download the app Givelify and give there also. But don't stop there. You can also scan the QR code and give there also, okay? But let's go a little farther. You can also text to give, all right? You can also download the app Church Ministry Buy One and give there also, okay? But look, we understand that everyone have not decided to come back in the sanctuary. So look, we also provided a way where you can mail your gift in. The address is 433 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Drive, right here in the great city of Jackson, Tennessee. Area code 38301. But listen, one last thing. Let me share this here with you. You can also log on to the World Wide Web and give at historicfirstbaptist.org/giving. All right? Listen, let us do this. Let us lift now our gifts up to the Lord, not to boast, but as Jesus did on that great day when he took the two fish and the five loaves, gave thanks to God, and God multiplied what was offered unto him. Father God, we thank you here this morning, God, for which you have given us, God. We thank you, God, because if it had not been for you, God, where would we be? We bring back today, God, by the act of obedience, but yet, God, by the way of faith, we bring back the tithes and the offering, God, that there may be food in your house, God, that ministry, God, that the preached word of Christ can not only abide just here alone inside of the walls of the church, God, but it may go abroad, God, in this city, in the nation, God, throughout the world, God. Give now some 30, 60, and 100-fold this day, God. It is in him who bled, died, and now who sits on the right hand of the Father, we give you thanks. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. If you will, real quickly, can I have my two outside rows to stand to my left and my right? Ushers, there into your hands.
None for me.
Come on, this is the wonderful day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Come on, happy Mother's Day to each of you. We are grateful for our mothers both here, and we pray for those whose mothers have transitioned to be with the Lord. We ask God's special blessings over your lives as you celebrate today with family, with other siblings, and with friends. Again, God has been kind to us to give us this day, and for that we're grateful. Amen. Listen, join me on your feet as we continue this morning through, again, our series in the book of Proverbs entitled Words to the Wise. Words to the wise. Words to the wise. I want to look at Proverbs chapter 16. Proverbs chapter 16. Proverbs chapter 16. I'll be reading from the New Living Translation. I just want to lift up three verses in this chapter. Proverbs chapter 16, verses 1, 2, and 3. Hear these words afresh with me this morning. We can make our own plans, but the Lord gives the right answer. People may be pure in their own eyes, but the Lord examines their motives. Commit your actions to the Lord, and your plans will succeed. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. You may be seated in the Lord's presence. I want to tag this particular proverb or set of verses by this title, Living to Succeed. living this life to succeed. Hear me again. I just shared on last week with our 10 a.m. service, and possibly you as well, as I preach this particular proverb. This word living can be defined as the means of having life or being alive, not dead. Living this life. This word life can be defined as the condition that distinguishes organisms from inorganic objects and dead organisms, being manifested by growth through metabolism, reproduction, and the power of adaptation to the environment through changes originating internally. It is the animate existence or period of animate existence of an individual, living this life to succeed. This word succeed can be defined as to happen or terminate according to desire, to turn out successfully, to have the desired result, to thrive, to prosper, to grow, or the like, to accomplish what is attempted or intended, to attain success in some popularly recognized form as wealth or standing. It is synonymous with words or phrases like to attain a good outcome, to benefit, to flourish, to gain, to triumph, to win. When James Garfield, later president of the United States, was principal of Hiram College in Ohio, a father asked him if the course of study could be simplified so that his son might go through by a shorter route. Certainly, Garfield replied, but it all depends on what you want to make of your boy. He said, when God wants to make an oak tree, he takes 100 years. He said, when he wants to make a squash, he only requires 2 months. He submits in his closing to this father, we're producing too many squashes and not enough oak trees in our day. John Wooden, that eminently successful basketball coach at UCLA during its dynasty years, was once asked his secret in producing stellar teams, successful teams. He answered with these words, we master the basics and we drill over and over again on the fundamentals. Family, this morning, allow me to take us back, if you will. Take us back to the basics given to us by Solomon in these wise words that were gifted to him so that we might be reminded of those things that are the essentials, those essentials that we must continue to drill over, over and over again and again, them that are the fundamentals. One school musician is recorded as saying that the conditions of success are always easy, and here they are. We have to toil a while, endure a while, and believe a while. Beloved, walk with me afresh through these 3 verses as we hear the essentials that are necessary in this present age for our success. Solomon says, the church, if we're going to be livers of this life, not just to exist, but to succeed, it's going to, in verse 1, require of us an attentive ear for and to the Lord. Listen to it again in verse 1. We can make our own plans, but the Lord gives the right answer. Child of God, Solomon submits that in our hands,
is the ability to make and to create and to arrange or to prepare our own plans. He suggests that there must be the toil of the inner man, the struggle of human effort, the mind, the will, the understanding of our emotions and passions to bring to life a strategy for whichever purpose that lies before us to accomplish. But while we are struggling, he submits, those who are godly, even those who are ungodly, we must be clear that it is only the Lord who provides for us, who is able to give us the right answer. That's why, beloved, it is important that we be sensitive to the voice of God and the sacrifice of our Christ through the person of the Holy Spirit in our lives as we work out our individual as well as collective purposes and dreams so that in the end we don't sabotage our todays and our tomorrows by the lack of attentiveness that we give to the Lord as we journey in this life. He has provided us health and strength for, and that he provides life and breath in, as we know in everything. Can I submit that we know what we know, but he knows what we need? And he also knows what it takes for us to succeed in our purpose in this life. Robert W. Vernon wrote in Homemade that good listening is like tuning into a radio station. For good results, you can listen to only one station at a time. Trying to listen, he shares, to my wife, he says, while looking over an office report is like trying to receive two radio stations at the same time. He said, I end up with distortion and frustration. He says, listening requires a choice of where I place my attention. To tune into my partner, he says, I must first choose to put away all that will divide my attention, that I might again mean laying down the newspaper, moving away from the dishes in the sink, putting down the book I am reading, and setting aside my projects that are on the table. And so, child of God, can I tell you in a much higher and holier sense that this is how we must seek to attune our lives to the Lord? The Bible says the plans belong to us as we work through them out in for implementation. But the answer, the response to be given on the matter toiled over belongs to the Lord. Church, we may devise it, but it is the Lord who shapes the language, who arranges the speech of our lips, the response of our inner wrestle, so that when it comes forth, you utter the right answer. Okay, can I tell you how glad I am? Not you, but can I tell you how glad I am that the Lord works through my inner struggle and lack of full awareness of this life I'm living to bring about and out of me the best. All right, let me say it this way. I'm so glad that God is in the details of my life, that he does not leave me to the whims of my unstable thinking. Because, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know about you, but there are times, if we're honest, that our decisions are not so straightforward. and we wrestle with what we want to say and think we need to say in our own humanity, but God works out our anger for our success. I know you think you have the best answer. Can I tell you that God is the one who gives us the right response for our success? There's something else in the text. Verse 2 says, I'm hurrying, that if we're going to succeed in this life that he is allowing us to live, then we must open our hearts to the Lord's behind-the-scenes examination. All right, here it is. People may be pure in their own eyes, but the Lord examines our motives. Kansuke Matsuhita, good word. Y'all didn't know your pastor had a little bit of articulation in his life. Founder of Panasonic, once shared the story of Zing Xin, who was young enough to be Confucius's grandson. Yet he won high praise from the old sage. One of the sayings from which Zing Xin is famous gives something, or goes something rather, like this. He says, every day I ask myself three questions. He says, the first is, have I sinned in my thoughts and actions towards others? The second is, have I broken faith in any of my friendships? And then the third is, have I tried to teach anything to others I have not fully learned and understood myself? Church, if Zing Xin asked himself these three questions every day, resolving to make no mistakes, then young as he was, we can as well understand why Confucius praised him. Not only is each of these three questions extremely important in itself, but the practice of examining one's own behavior every day is a habit that every leader should cultivate. Church, now I'm in no way an advocate of Confucianism, but this illustration captured me as it helps us to walk deeper into Solomon's intent for the first verse, again opening to us our understanding of listening and now literally submitting to us that we have to be careful in this second verse of self-deception. And the only way, ladies and gentlemen, to overcome self-deception is by way of divine examination. Family, you do know that it is very possible for you and for I to be deceived by ourselves, even when we are asking ourselves the best of questions outside of the Holy Spirit. But even those of us who are saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Spirit, we can so live out of tune with God that we make mistakes in listening and hearing and responding to the voice of God. And can I say without much contradiction that it is possible for the believer to look at his or her life and determine in their mind a course of action or emotion and think that what they are doing is pleasing in the Lord's sight because it's pleasing in their own sight. But can I tell you that what, again, this wonderful God, again, teaches us through the words of Solomon is that God is not interested so much in what you say or what you do, but the motive, the spirit behind what you are saying and doing. Okay, come with me back to 1 Samuel chapter 16. Y'all didn't read your Bible when you were growing up. 1 Samuel chapter 16. Let me see if I can make this make sense in verses 1 through 7. You remember the story of David's anointing as king when God unseats Saul as king and seats David as king while Saul is still on the throne. If you don't, I'll read it to you. It says this, beginning at verse 1, chapter 16, 1 Samuel. The Lord said to Samuel, how long will you go on grieving over Saul? I have rejected him as king of Israel. But now get some olive oil and go to Bethlehem to a man named Jesse because I've chosen one of his sons to be king. How can I do that? Samuel asked. If Saul hears about it, he will kill me. The Lord answered, take a calf with you and say that you are there to offer a sacrifice to the Lord. Invite Jesse to the sacrifice and I will tell you what to do. You will anoint as king the man I tell you to. Samuel did what the Lord told him to do. Went to Bethlehem where the city leaders came, trembling to meet him and asked, is this a peaceful visit, seer? Yes, he answered, I have come to offer sacrifice to the Lord. Purify yourselves and come with me. He also told Jesse and his sons to purify themselves, and he invited them to the sacrifice. When they arrived, hear me, Samuel saw Jesse's son Eliab and said to himself, this man standing here is the Lord's presence, is surely the one he has chosen. But then God speaks and the Lord says to Samuel, pay no attention to how tall and how handsome he is. I have rejected him because I don't judge as people judge. They look at the outward appearance, but I look at the heart. Could it be, child of God, hear me, that the reason why many of us are in the positions that we are in, unhappy, unsettled, uneasy, ready to quit on life, angry at the world, frustrated with your life, is because you are viewing it, we are viewing it, and responding to this life through impure eyes. Many of us literally think that everything we do is right. This word pure in the text occurs four times in the Pentateuch, speaking of pure oil or frankincense, which was used in Israel's worship. Here it describes in our text one's moral judgment of his own conduct. Church, Solomon says, in the words of the Message Bible translation, that humans are satisfied with whatever looks good. But God probes for what is good. Church, he submits that we need to be careful to allow the Lord to search us so that success achieved might be success sustained. So that when we reach that place he has destined for us, we are not looking over our shoulders or peeping around the corners for that one decision made without proper examination that could unravel the good thing that he has done in our lives. Now, let me tell someone listening who's in a hurry, hear me before you do it, to shed tears, upset over those things that you've done, without allowing the Lord to do proper examination. Let me help you. You can't change your past, but you can determine to live right now, allowing the Lord to search your heart, to examine your ways, to weigh your motives, to balance your intent so that he might get glory out of you and so that others may benefit from the best of you and so that you might be better for it. Here it is. My grandmother and my mother would say it this way. in song fashion. And Lord, if you find anything that shouldn't be, take it out and strengthen me. I want to be right. I want to be saved. I want to be whole. Help me here. Then David would help us. Let me give you scripture. Come along in the 139th Psalm, beginning at verse 1. I'm going to read a lengthy passage, but I need you to hear it, concluding at verse 18 and say, O Lord, you have examined my heart, and you know everything about me. You know when I sit down and stand up. You know my thoughts even when I'm far away. You see me when I travel and when I am at rest. You know everything I do. You know what I'm doing, what I'm going to say, rather, even before I say it. Lord, you go before me and follow me. You place your hand of blessing on my head. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, David says. Too great for me to understand. I can never escape your spirit. I can never get away from your presence. If I go up to heaven, he says, you're there. If I go down to the grave, you're there. If I ride the wings of the morning, if I dwell by the furthest oceans, even there your hand will guide me and your strength will support me. I could ask the darkness to hide me and the light around me to become night, but even in the darkness, David says, I cannot hide from you. To you, night shines as bright as day. Darkness and light are the same to you. You made all the delicate inner parts of my body and knit me together in my mother's womb. Thank you, he says, for making me so wonderfully complex. Your workmanship is marvelous. How well I know it. You watched me as I was being formed in utter seclusion, as I was woven together in the dark of the womb. You saw me before I was born, David says. He closes by saying, every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. How precious are your thoughts about me, O God. They cannot be numbered. I can't even count them. They outnumber the grains of sand. And when I wake up, you are still there. I'm done. Child of God, if we're going to succeed in this life, if we're going to live this life to succeed, remember first, we must be careful to pay attention to listen for, and listen to the Lord's voice as we work out our salvation with fear and trembling. Family, if we're going to live this life to succeed, then we must remember, second, that we must allow our motives to be weighed, to be examined by the purity, not of our own diluted and tainted knowledge, but by and through the undiluted and untainted wisdom of the Lord. But lastly, Solomon says in verse 3 that if we're going to live this life to succeed, then, hear me, we must surrender our ways to his will. Listen to verse 3. Commit your actions to the Lord, and your plans will succeed. Now, I need y'all to listen to me. This word surrender means to yield to the possession or power of another, to deliver up possession of on demand or under duress, to give oneself up, to abandon oneself to relinquish one comfort and hope to. It is synonymous with words like resignation, submission, to entrust to deliver up, to give over. Solomon says that we need to commit. Let me unpack this word commit. Commit in the text means that we need to roll, okay, to roll away to roll down, to roll together, ultimately to roll up on the Lord. Okay. Child of God, Solomon says that if we're going to succeed, if we will be made firm and established, then we have to be willing to completely commit to roll our lives onto Him who is the Lord, our actions, our deeds, our work, our pursuits, our labor, our undertakings, our life's enterprise, our everyday walk. We must be willing to roll upon the Lord. And how do you do that? In prayer. We must be individuals who are committed to the moment of prayer so that everything we do is rolled upon the Lord. Can I help you, church? The good or the bad, we must be willing to cast, to throw all our cares upon the Lord. First Peter says, knowing that the Lord cares for us. Child of God, we need to every day wake up committing to the rolling upon the Lord all of our actions. Andrew Murray shared that God is ready to assume full responsibility for the life that is wholly yielded to Him, which means if you're ready to roll, God is ready to receive. Bruce Larson tells how he helped people struggling to surrender their lives to Christ. Hear this illustration. He would share that for many years he worked in New York City and counseled at his office any number of people who were wrestling with this yes or no decision to whatever it might have been. Often, he said, I would suggest they walk with me from my office down to the RCA building on Fifth Avenue. He says, in the entrance of that building, there is a gigantic statue of Atlas. You know who Atlas is? A beautifully proportioned man, he shares, who with all his muscles is straining to hold the world upon his shoulders. He says, there he is, the most powerfully built man in the world, and he can barely stand under this burden. He said, now that's one way to live, he tells that client, that person, him or her, as he would point out, trying to carry the world on your shoulders. He said, but then he would ask them to come across the street with him. And on the other side of Fifth Avenue is St. Patrick's Cathedral. If you've ever been to New York, you've seen it. And there behind the high altar is a little shrine of the boy Jesus, perhaps 8 or 9 years old. And with no effort at all, when you look at that shrine, the boy Jesus is holding the world in one hand. He said he would point out to him or her, those who would walk with him, illustrated graphically, that we have a choice. He would conclude by saying, we can carry the world on our shoulders. Or we can, he says, give it up to the Lord and say, here's my life. I give you my world, the whole world. I'm trying to help somebody. Y'all still ain't getting it. Today, you need to roll the world off of your shoulders. Because why carry on your shoulders what he has in his hands? Y'all know we used to sing that as a little child. He got the whole world in his hands. He got the whole world. He got you and me, baby, in his hands. He got you and he's got the whole wide. What, y'all still didn't get it. Let me see. Y'all like Bible. I know y'all are Bible church. David says it this way in Psalm 37, verse 1 through 6. He says, don't worry about the wicked or envy those who are doing wrong. For like grass, they soon fade away. Like spring flowers, they soon wither. Trust in the Lord and do good. Then you will live safely in the land and prosper. Take delight in the Lord, and he will give you your heart's desires. Commit everything you do to the Lord. Trust him, and he will help you. He will make your innocence radiate like the dawn, and the justice of your cause will shine like the noonday sun. I'm done. But when you trust the Lord enough to roll your life upon his life and to roll your life within his life, success is yours and your plans will succeed. Hear me, not because of who you are, but because of what he did. Songwriter says, y'all remember, I turned it over to the Lord and he worked it out. And then somebody holler, oh, y'all can't, y'all ain't been to church in a long time. Let me help you. Because I'm trying to tell somebody who's listening to me this morning that he will let my, hear me clearly, right plan, that he has approved for my path for me succeed. And I need to tell somebody else, listen to me, so that you're not mistaken. Everything you roll upon the Lord will not come back stamped approved. Yo, I just need to drop that in on my way out of here. But out of all that you roll upon him, everything that is for you and for your path, he will allow you to succeed in those and in them that he has approved for your life, because it's for your good. Can I tell you why? I'm gonna say it just as simply as this: because he's a good, good daddy. Are y'all listening to me? I'm done. But I hear the prophet Jeremiah, because y'all don't believe it, he's beckoning us to Jeremiah chapter 29, verses 10 through 11. Hear this. He says, this is what the Lord says. You will be in Babylon for 70 years, but then I will come and do for you all the good things I have promised. And I will bring you home again, for I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not disaster, to give you a future and a hope. I know you're struggling right now because, again, you're still in that pandemic mindset. But can I tell you that Babylon don't last always? Can I tell you that God, even in your Babylon, is suggesting to you that there are better days ahead for you, that there's a wonderful future that he has planned for you. So stop living your life as if God is done. It's God who approves. It's God, that's what it's saying, who establishes. Which means that true success of who we are and what we do is not in our hands, but it is in his hands. That's why I don't know why songs just keep popping up. All in his hands. I put it, we sing that song all the time, but the truth is we really don't do it. But we ought to roll all of our cares into his hands. And since that day, he has been working it out for my good. I know the day I gave him my life, I've seen better days. But if I'm honest, let me help you. If I'm honest, child of God, there are still times that I fall short of rolling my troubles upon him. There's still times when I grow weak of trusting the fact that God can handle everything in my life. But even when I don't roll it on him, he still asks for it. Come here, let me see if I can give you a better illustration. It was on Calvary. You do know we didn't ask for Calvary. He just gave it to us. We didn't ask him to die. He chose to die. We didn't ask him to cover us with his blood. He chose to cover us with his blood. He asked me for my sins and then gave me his salvation. Is there anybody here? way to my seat now. But I need you to understand that if you're going to live this life to succeed, you got to turn it over to the Lord. And watch him. Watch him work it out. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yay! Yes, sir.
His name, for the Lord is good. Yeah, yeah. Oh, bless his name. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, thank you. That bless my soul. Living to succeed. Living to succeed. I was sitting in my seat and I thought about the other side of the coin. I had to ask myself, do anybody plan not to succeed? Do anybody live to fail? Or do us as African Americans live to succeed? And the question I say, I think that we all make plans to succeed. The pastor shared with us, he said that one of the first requirements is to have an ear. For the Bible says to let the church hear what the Spirit is saying unto the church. I think that is very, very important in the life of every believer. It's one of the things that we all have to develop somewhere alone as we travel through salvation, is to develop an ear to hear what the Lord is saying. What I like about the ear is that God's language is not our language. God has many voices. Many times he speaks through the preacher. And bringing yet the necessary word that we need in our time of need. Let us hear what the preacher is saying. That's what we as the church have found counsel, is that when I need to hear from the Lord, if I can only get to church, if I can get there, I believe I hear from the Lord. And then he goes on to say that in many of our troubles, it is rooted in self-centeredness. Self-centeredness is the root of all of our problems. It is the failure in our purpose to succeed. Self-centeredness is. It is yet again the root of all our problems. But I tell you here this morning, you can change, as he said, your past. Excuse me, you can't change your past. But what I love about that, he said that God can change your future. I encourage here this morning, everyone in the sanctuary and those who are online, if self-centeredness has been the root of all of our problems, let us now commit to the ways of the Lord. For the ways of the Lord is right. There is success in the Lord. And the truth of the fact is that every believer knows, if he'll be honest with he or she themselves, that God is the answer. that at the end of the day, in the midst of the darkness, as I wait in that fetal position, I know that God is the answer. I encourage today those here in the sanctuary and also online, hearken not thy heart this morning. Don't let this be the last time that God, that you respond to God. When we hear the voice of God, God is looking for us to respond, not later, not tomorrow, not when I get home, not when I get through eating, but right now. Right now. The doors of the church is open. Let me share this here with you. If you ain't saved, you need to be saved. Because there is success in the will of God. It is there that we find safety. It is there that God makes everything all right. If you need prayer, we want to pray with you also. We want to sit with you, go before the throne of God with you in prayer on your behalf. Or maybe at this time that you're looking for a church home. I believe this. I think you tuning in here this morning, or you being here in this sanctuary, I do believe that this is where God wants you to be. He wants you to be in a Bible-based church where you're able to hear the word of the Lord. This morning, we offer Christ to you.
We offer Christ to you, oh my brother. Christ to you, oh my sister. He will give you brand new life, he'll give you life abundantly. So
say this one more time. I don't care how far down the scale you have fallen, or what dark place you may be in this morning, I assure you this, God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, and above all you can ask or even think. Our God is able. Yes, he is. I'm a living witness. I've been in some dark places in my life. And if it had not been for the Lord, where would I be? And let me say this again. If you ain't saved, you need to be saved. Don't pass up this opportunity, because again, tomorrow ain't promised. Amen. Well, at this time, let us hear from our media.
Baptist Church, a church with a welcome always. Sunday, May 14th, 2023. Happy Mother's Day. The announcements. Senior Care Spring Fling, that's May 17th, 2023, gets underway at 12 noon. Help us kick off our Senior Spring Fling Bible study. For fun, you can take part in the Bible trivia and church bingo. Prizes, gifts, and refreshments will be provided. May Awareness Month, Mental Health Awareness Month, American Stroke Awareness Month, and Lupus Awareness Month. Browns Creek District Association upcoming events for the month of May. May 15th, Women's Night of Prayer. That takes place at the Home Missionary Baptist Church. May 20th, Second Quarterly Evangelism Meeting. That's at Rehoboth Baptist Church. And May 26th through 27th, BCDA Women's Retreat, Pickwick Landing Lodge in Counts, Tennessee. Men's Ministry Man Cave, that's tomorrow beginning at 6 p.m. All men are welcome. WT Webb Christian Leadership School, all classes from May 15th through the 18th. Times are 6:30 p.m. through 8:30 p.m., virtual. Women's Ministry Reconnect, that's Monday, May 22nd beginning at 5:30 p.m. Calling all women of HFBC, Jackson, and surrounding areas. You're invited to join the women of HFBC as we reconnect in sisterhood and fellowship. That takes place in the HFBC Fellowship Hall. Coming in June, Historic First Baptist Church Summer Revival. Join us every Wednesday night in June beginning at 6:30 p.m. That's for an evening of renewal and restoration. Giving Sunday, First and Second Sunday, Vision. Third Sunday, Benevolence. Fourth Sunday, Scholarship. Fifth Sunday, Mission. HFBC Noon and Evening Bible Study is resumed. 12 p.m. for Lunch and Learn. That's in the HFBC Fellowship Hall. Lunch is provided at noon. 6 p.m. for Evening Session. That's in the HFBC Sanctuary. Dinner is provided at 5:30 p.m. Classes available for all ages, CIA and youth in session. HFBC Bible Reading Plan, a chronological tour through the scriptures with special emphasis on Sundays. May 2023, celebrating our graduates. The mission of Historic First Baptist Church is to seek, save, and make disciples of those who are lost to the glory of God. The vision of Historic First Baptist Church is to become a key in the life of this community and our global society, unlocking its power and potential to the glory of God by providing hope, unity, and a Bible-based belief system. In-person worship service, 8 a.m. and 10 a.m., virtual 5 p.m. every Saturday and Sunday. Temperature checks no longer required. Masks are optional. Live streaming is available on HFBC website, HFBC YouTube, and HFBC Facebook. We'd love the opportunity to pray for you. Submit your prayer request to prayer@historicfirstbaptistchurch.org. We are prayerful to continue to be good stewards of our resources in benefit to our church operations, church family, and our community. Historic First Baptist Church, celebrating 155 years.
Let us continue to hold ourselves accountable to our announcements here this morning. From the pastoral office, join us for our first ever summer revival 2023 as we make the turn in this year of reconstruction. We will sure up the first half of our time of worship together as we seek to be revived and refreshed and to finish the work of this year strong. Coming up in June, Wednesdays, June the 7th, the 14th, the 21st, and the 28th will start off our June revival. Okay? Ministry volunteers are needed. Let me say that again. Ministry volunteers are needed. Every member serving takes the weight off every member that always are serving. So find your area of giftedness and get involved. We cannot do great ministry without you. Let me say that again. We cannot do great ministry without you. All right? Man Cave Monday, tomorrow, May the 15th at 6 p.m., we will be concluding our study through the book Kingdom Men Rising by Dr. Tony Evans. Also, let us remember WT Webb Leadership School session for the month of May begins, all right? Women Reconnect Monday is May the 22nd. Graduation, Dr. Chapman and Dr. LaDonna Braswell. Let us give them a hand clap here this morning. All right. Birthdays this week. Kristen Barron, Daryl Carroll, Joseph Braden, Stephen Chapman, Nicholas Darnell, Wendolyn Kenton, and Teresa Campbell. You see these members, wish them a happy birthday, all right? At this time, I give you our pastor, Pastor Watson.
Hey, man, come on. Listen, one of my members told me I need to take her name off the list. I ain't gonna tell you who it is. Because y'all don't even know when her birthday is. So y'all, when y'all see her partying, just know she parties all the time, all right? So I apologize if you heard your name and it was on the list. Bless your heart. Amen. To our mothers again, happy Mother's Day. Come on, let's celebrate our mothers. We thank God for you. All of you should have received a gift. You should have received a gift. Our children and our youth made gifts for every mother, and so you should have received a gift. So when you see one of our children and youth, give them a hug, because that is their special gift to you. Amen. And so we thank God for how they love on their mothers and the mothers of this church. Now, that's mothers biologically. That's godmothers. That is aunties who have been mothers, sisters who've had to be mothers. So we thank God for all of our mothers. Amen. Let's stand together. Looking forward to seeing you this Wednesday in Bible study, but also looking forward to seeing you next Sunday as we continue our walk through the book of Proverbs, this series, Wise Words. Wise words, words for the wise. Listen, thank you so much for your presence here on today. Make sure, children, celebrate your moms, all right? And for those of you who are grieving a mom, we're praying for you. We're praying your strength. We're praying you're able to continue to enjoy this day that the Lord has made, knowing that that loved one is wonderfully with the Lord. Amen. Amen. Look this way. Let me bless you now. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to smile upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift the countenance of his presence upon you and give you his peace in your laughter and in your leisure, in your frustration, and even in your tears, until we shall all one day sit at the feet of Jesus where there is no sunrise or sunset. Listen, God bless y'all. I love y'all. Looking forward to seeing you this Wednesday in Bible study. Be encouraged.